seat, so try not to touch anything while we're in the air. There was a little bit of a mix-up with the paperwork, actually. Yeah, yesterday I said we were going to be flying this up to Anapa, but we're actually just going to be flying from here in Sukhumi, past Skudata, which is just up the coast, and then turning inland, and we're going to fly a short scenic flight through the mountains into Sochi. It should be a really, really nice flight. The sun's not quite up yet, so we're going to have that nice early view of the stars, and we should have a very nice sunrise while we're in the air. This aircraft is one of the Russian acrobatic aircraft for one of their teams, and it was just down here for some maintenance work, so we're taking it back up to Sochi, where the actual pilot who is actually going to fly it is staying, and the rest of his team's actually flying down similar time to us. So if we're lucky, we should kind of arrive at a similar time. If not, we'll see them on the ground. Okay, well, if you want to get comfortable in the back and make sure you're all strapped in, I'm going to get started in starting this aircraft up. You can follow along if you want, or you can just sit back and relax like last time, and we'll be up in the air shortly. So I need to tune in for Gudata first, which I'll do in a second. I'm just going to put my kneeboard away. And I'm going to turn the battery on. And with the battery on, I'm going to turn on the red lights, because they're quite nice at night. You know, as you can see, the sun's already starting to rise, so best to make this a little bit quick. Okay, I'm going to turn engine control. Avionics, radios, RSPN navigation system. I'm just going to switch these on now. Gens can stay off and the inverters can come on. Okay, I'm going to set the parking brake, check the fuel is on. Circuit breakers are in. I'm going to switch the lights on. I'm going to switch them to switch into fixed for now. And it's going to get loud, so I'm just going to close the canopy. I find the handle is a bit dark, so it's kind of hard to see where my handle is. There we go. Just lock the canopy. Okay. Here we go. Start the auxiliary power unit, which is actually going to be used to start the engine. That's just the radar altimeter telling us it basically sees us that we're under the 100 meter minimum altitude, so it's giving us a warning, but it's okay because we're on the ground. Okay, now that's on, I'm going to hit the starter, and we're going to watch and monitor the RPM. As you can see, the what we call the N1 is spooling up. Once the second one starts to budge and it's stabilized, we're going to move the throttle up and the engine's going to start. And we're just going to check that the temperature does not exceed 600 on startup. As you heard, the auxiliary power unit turned off. And I'm just going to select the flaps up. That's a good start. I'm gonna push this knob here forward, and it's gonna start the air conditioning and pressurization of the cabin. Now that's all started, turn the generators on. We have amps. So the batteries are charging. Just going to verify that the oxygen is open and check the quantity. Just heard a slightly garbled radio call from the other acrobatic aircraft. I think they have just taken off. Okay, so the aircraft is now all started up, and I'm going to bring up my kneeboard again, and I'm going to check data, which has a NDB or non-directional beacon marker with a megahertz of 395. I'm going to program that in. Now this is going into the ADF. The ADF system, which is a radio-based navigation, and we use this instrument here to give a direction to that beacon. So I'm just gonna zoom in and look down here, lean my head down. I'm just gonna turn it to sound, but actually no, we'll keep the sound off and we'll just run with this little dial. I've forgotten what it was. 395, and then Sochi as one of 7617. So we change this one. 7 6 1. Okay. And this one already giving us a direction. Yep. Okay. I think we are ready to take off. Well, we're ready to taxi. So let's taxi to the runway. We are at Sukhumi. So let's find Sukhumi on the charts. Sukhumi Babushara. So we're at the moment on apron 3. The active runway is 29. So we're going to taxi forward, taxi right, and follow those lights up there all the way down to the runway. And when we depart, we'll just depart straight out, and then we'll turn and follow the coast. Oh, it's getting light already. I'm just going to turn the taxi lights on. Here we go. Oh, I might want to bring the brake off. Oh, it looks like someone's just landed. It's by the looks of it, it's an Antonov. Turboprop. We'll just follow the taxiway all the way down towards the runway. Just follow these lights. quite surprised. It seems that the sun is rising over there quite quickly. Thought we would have had a little bit more time. Oh, there we go. Look at that. It's another. It's a regional airliner just taking off. I wonder where they're off to. Taxiing just a little bit too fast, so I'm going to bring the throttle back to idle until we slow down. Look at that, look the way that the sun is lighting up the horizon with a beautiful red glow. I can't wait to get in the air and see what it looks like. On the ground, just because of the way the braking system works. It's not like most European and American aircraft where the nose wheel, like on an American aircraft, the nose wheel will normally steer for you. Well, for some aircraft, where this has a free castering one, so it doesn't, it's not locked, and basically use the brakes to steer yourself. So when I want to turn, I have to push the rudder to the right, press the brake, and then the right brake brakes more than the left. So there's no actual steering, it's just all done with different amounts of brake pressure. Okay, here we are. The threshold. Looks like our charts might be slightly wrong because they said it was runway 29, where that says runway 30. Okay, we're just gonna stop here. I'm gonna select one notch of flaps for takeoff. I'm just gonna run up the engine on the brake and check all the temperatures. Just monitor the temps. Yeah, temp's good. Oil pressure is good. Everything looks fine. I'm just gonna check the emergency fuel delivery system. And that is working sufficiently. Check the engine vibration. Light comes on. That's fine. Everything seems fine to me. Let's go. Okay, I'm gonna pull the brake off. And it's taxi onto the runway. There we go. And I'm just going to do a control check, so other side. Up. Down. All flight controls are free and clear. Okay. Here we go. Throttling up. Rolling. Airspeed's alive. K 160. Positive rate. Gas coming up. Taxi light off. Trim for that climb. Okay, we're trimmed. There we go. She's buying the air now. So those temps on the climb out. Oil pressure is good. Temp's good. Fuel is good. I forgot to mention where actually if you look out on the wing. See those big yellow tanks? We're actually carrying the external fuel tanks as well. We kinda have to because otherwise they'll have to put them on a truck and send them up, so we might as well just carry them on the flight. So we're going to climb up through just over 1K and then we'll turn towards the coast and follow the coastline. Quite need the red lights as much, so I'm going to turn those down a little bit. And since it is a bit cold, I'm going to turn the pedo heaters on. Oh, there we go. Left and right. These aircraft have those tubes on each side. Those are the pedo tubes, and what they do is they measure the airspeed. So we have a nice accurate airspeed indicator. Basically what the heating does is prevents ice from building up on the little piece on the front, because otherwise we'll end up with no airspeed indicator. Oh. Sorry, I just need to have a small drink. Make a nice change from the B-51 though. That aircraft never really had a second seat. Like it was it's a bit of a botched job fitting it in. They had to take the fuel tank out of it to fit one in, where in this it was built from the ground up as a training aircraft. Extremely popular. This aircraft was built. The type was first introduced in, your first flight was 1968, but introduced in 1972 by the Czech Air Force, and I think almost 3,000 of them were built. I'm just gonna pull the throttle back a little bit. Sun's just rising. You can still see the stars though. Very nice. I wonder where that airliner is now. So, if you look out on the right wing, all the way out there, see all those mountains? On the other side of them is Russia. So, when we get a little bit further up the coast, we'll turn inland and fly through the mountains. We might descend down a little bit, because that'd be really quite pretty. So yeah, like I said, this aircraft was used a lot by the Soviet Air Force and all the old Eastern Bloc countries, and it was used as the intermediate trainer between what would be your initial training aircraft, like a Yak, like a little propeller aircraft, and then you go into this aircraft, and then you go from that to a MiG-21 or a MiG-29 or Su-27, like a fast jet. So, the layout of the cockpit is quite similar to a MiG-29 or something. And it's meant to introduce young student pilots to flying jets, and also flying instrument flight rules and instrument landings. Because it actually has a... Oh, just descend a little bit down to... I'll go down to 1200. It has like a hood that can fold down over the front person's eyes so they can practice instrument land, like instrument flying. That's why I said try and keep your hands off the controls while we're flying, because in the back, that's where the instructor would normally sit. So you've got control over everything, technically, in the back. But, yeah, just keep your hands to yourself and that'll be fine. We've rewired a lot of the things in this anyway, because the aerobatic teams use this aircraft and take people up in the back. So when they're in the back, they don't interfere with the pilot too much. But if this was an original L-39, like used by the Air Force back in the day, then the instructors, the backseater, can override all the controls. Of my little book. Okay, so we fly over Gudara, and there should be a little valley up in the... I'm just going to turn left a little bit. Down below us now is Gudara, which is a small airport. I'm going to turn left and I'm going to swing right again so you can look out the right window and you'll be able to see it. Not quite yet. just went over the marker. Let's say, landing marker. There we go. And there you can see that that's where the valley that we're gonna follow starts. So, as I said before, it burns quite a lot of fuel, so we've got to keep an eye on that little gauge down there. Currently says 700 kgs. We start off with over 800, so yeah, definitely burns a bit. And we're not even going flat out. Suns came up, stars are fading and turning into a beautiful day. Some scattered clouds, but overall a pretty beautiful day. Okay, I'm gonna switch the navigation over to the Sochi NDB, and I thank you. Those binoculars out that are set in the back. You can see way out there. That airbase is Sochi, so that's where we're flying. And we could fly direct, but I thought it'd be quite nice to fly a little bit into the mountains and have a little look around. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna descend. Don't worry, we've already got clearance to do this. We're gonna descend down and do a little bit of low altitude flying. So I'm gonna decrease the throttle and I'm gonna open the air brakes. This aircraft is fitted with some basically pop out boards that come out the bottom of the aircraft to help slow us down. They also come out automatically if we go too fast in this aircraft as well, to prevent damage to the aircraft. Here we go. Down we go. Unfortunately, it looks like the snow has melted since I was last up here, but that's okay. And now we're going to level off, and we're going to accelerate again. So I'm just going to make sure we're trimmed, nice and level, and we're going to accelerate. Up to 100% again. And we're gonna fly through the mountains. I'll just bring up my little notepad so I remember my route through the mountains. Start by flying straight through here, then turn right, left, and then hop across the next valley. So a nice smooth right turn. Very nice. Just a couple bumps, but that's normal. Little pockets of air as we fly through the mountain, it's perfectly normal. I've flown here through here snow and then the wind. The aircraft's being bumped around all over the place. That does get exciting. Nice turn. Follow it right again. And where is she going to go? Up here. Still down here. The sun hasn't quite made it. It's actually probably the least stressful ride this aircraft has actually had. This is used normally for some of those extreme aerobatics you see at air shows. Sorry, it's a little bit bumpy up here. But I suppose that's the least you can pay for beautiful views and amazing sunrise over the mountaintops. See, even though it looks like we're flying level, we're actually climbing quite steeply. So I'm just gonna push up the throttle to maximum just while we go over this. And for a little aircraft, it actually has quite a lot of power. Just gonna pull the throttle back again to 100. And yep, this is the valley we want. We're gonna follow this valley all the way down. There's a river here, and I'm pretty sure this river will take us all the way to Sochi. Actually get some speed up down here. I'm gonna set the altitude warner, if I can see, down to 50 meters. Down into the valley a little bit more. Here we go. Nice little blast down the canyon. Don't mind the occasional jostle. There's just a few little pockets of turbulence, but nothing this little aircraft. can't blaspheme. From the mountains. We'll have to fly through there, fly up to the actual snow-capped mountains when we're in Scenic a little faster. And here we go. Just gonna get my approach plate out for Sochi. Find it. Sochi. Where are you? Sochi. There we go. Okay. Fine. There's the airfield there. Okay. We're coming from there. Our throttle. Speed breaks out. And we're going to line up with the runway. And we'll just overfly it once to check that it's clear. Just going to trim the aircraft nice and stable. See something out to the ocean. One sec. Just grab my binoculars. Look out there. Oh, there's a couple of aircraft out there coming in. Well, we'll just circle around and watch for a second. There's another L-39, I think. Ah, it's probably the Russian jet team. Just arriving before us. Pretty great timing. There's one of them. Oh, two of them together. Wonder if they'll land together. Together. 1, 2, 3. Wow, short landings as well. I wonder where the final one is. There's normally 4 aircraft. Oh, it appears that this is the active runway, so it's actually 06. checks out. Let's arrest that speed a little and decrease our throttle down to 90. Stage. There we go, gears down. Brakes out. Bit of a bumpy landing, but there's a little bit of a crosswind there. Go flaps up. Yeah. No matter how much you fly these aircraft, occasionally you just get like a gusty, turbulent wind just when you're landing, and it can be a little bit bumpy. There's no doubt going to be a beautiful day in Sochi. Flick our lights to taxi. Just, I'll get ready to depressurize the cockpit in a sec. You know, these guys are there. Are they taxiing over there, or are they gonna park? I think they're taxiing all the way out. Off, taxi light off, leader heat off, turn the SDU, de-icing, wing tanks, RSBN, inverters, leave the engine. engine control on. Generators off. Okay. And we're gonna hit. I'm pretty sure that's the emergency one. We're gonna push the throttle back to the cutoff detent. And the engine will shut down. Engine control. Near the fan blade still turning. Okay, that's everything, and we'll just turn off the battery. Okay, well, welcome to Sochi. Not quite sure how we're gonna get back down to Sukhumi, but I'm sure we will find something to do while we're up here. I think I've got a friend who might have something that we can play around with, like an old helo, or maybe an old, I think there's someone here who's got an old BF-109 or FW-190, one of those old German aircraft from World War II, so might be able to have a fly up in one of those, or if not, maybe one of the helicopters or something. Well, I'm sure we'll find something to do up here before we have to go back down to Sukhumi to pick up the B-51. I shall catch you guys soon.